So guys, what month was it that we actually started recording Humble Folks?
I think it was it November 2015? If Humble Folks came out in April 2016,
mm-hmm. that was... May came out in May, and then we wanted to follow it up soon, so
with the
single. Started working in the fall.
Yeah, so we started with Feb Snow in November, and then, that was what? 1, 2, 3, 7, or 6, my math is horrible, 5 months?
Quick before. Turnaround.
Yeah.
I don't know how we did that. We didn't sleep.
That's the time that the board crashed?
Or, yeah. Oh, right? Lord. Yeah. So, for me, one of the most nightmarish experiences was that literally the week I was supposed to start mixing this, and we were on a tight deadline. I remember being like, oh my gosh, I don't even know if I can get it done, you know? And my wonderful pride and joy Amec console decided to give up the ghost and roasted. Oh. Like, I had 2 weeks and I had to start with a completely new rig. I had to get a new power supply, could not get here in time because it's a 25-year-old console. And so, but I actually think that that's one of the things that made it successful is that it, like, I was broken out of my box because I didn't have any of my normal tools.
Yeah.
And so I had to really strive for that. There were a couple crazy moments. Like, I don't know who it was that decided to do a song the Thursday night before we needed to lock the record.
Yeah.
You want to talk about that?
Yeah. We were talking about that at rehearsal, just kind of, remember calling Scott and saying, man, or showing Jason, like, in the kitchen, this, like, little slinky kind of folky acoustic kind of finger-picking thing. He's like, man, that feels good. And I was like, I think this is what Humble Folks sounds like, you know? So, we tried to write to that. And then I remember we wrote it and played it, and he's like, man, that's fucking cool. You should beep. He's like, that's cool, you know? Like, we should bring that to Scott. And I just remember being like, dude, Scott's gonna be so pissed. Also, Scott's the kind of guy that will, like, turn over every stone, you know, and so I remember when I told you, I was like, hey, I know Caitlin Butts is coming in tonight, and we barely have enough time for her to sing, you know, on this record. She's coming in to do a Life We Work Out.
That's right, I forgot about that, yeah.
And I remember I was like, hey man, we got one more song, dude, it could be the title track, like, would you be willing? I just bet you were just like, I knew what you were probably thinking, but you were like, all right, let's bring it, let's check it out. And I just showed you on the couch, and I remember, like, playing it, you know, and it was like, and I was tapping my foot, and then you actually mic'd it.
That's
and
right.
We started,
right,
like, there.
And
I just remember, you know, we all live tracked it as a band, and that was kind of sonically, I feel like, because the rest of the record, you know, we'd come in and track together, but then you piece it together like a puzzle, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that was the first song that we had just went for it because we didn't have time to make it perfect,
just
right?
Tracked it live,
and it
right?
sounded like that on the record, and it kind of opened the door, I think, for the next album. Because you could have been like, we don't have time, and we would have had 10 songs.
Yeah, I remember that. You wanted it to be 11, like,
yeah,
so
like,
bad.
Yeah,
I mean, forgot about that. Yeah, like, it was like, I don't know what it was, but you knew.
It was like the extra mile, you know, like a full LP seems like you had 10.
Well, to me, that's where magic happens. And magic is not about being safe, and magic is sometimes not about, you know, being kind to your body or sleeping or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, so screw sleep, we didn't need any of that, you know. Yeah. But I remember tracking that night and then literally rough mixing it, and that's what went on the record. Mm-hmm. I mean, we talked a little the next day, do we want to do anything else, and we didn't have time because Katie came in, which is crazy because you guys met in this room, you know, and then Will was here, I remember, and then I had to start mixing on Monday, and that's the day my Amec blew. It was like, oh my gosh, yeah, that was freaking insane. But I've got to hand this to you, Cleto, that pulling that track at the last second, it's the one that pulled the entire project together, because I remember being titleless. We didn't know what to do. And when you called and you said, hey, you're gonna hate me, but I think I've got one, and I think it's the title track. And when I heard it, I was like, we have to. And during that time period, the way the scene was going, everybody was trying to be big, everybody was trying to be rock and roll, you know what I mean, all of that. And you guys chose Humble Folks. you went the exact opposite direction. And I think it was a breath of fresh air to everybody out there, to be honest with you. And I think that's why it hit, you know. So kudos to you for having that vision, dude. That's a rare thing.
Thanks for trusting us kids with giving us a lot of freedom, you know, to create. Yeah. And I think all of us look up to you in that regards. And we carry that with us, you know, on the road. And we still try to be those kids, you know.
Well, guys, I just want to thank you for coming here and doing this here at the studio. This is just going to be so much fun.
Thanks for welcoming us back home, man. It's been a good time.
Yeah, it is.
want you, girl, I mean it. When I say I love you, you're gonna feel it. Each and every day I go out of my way, above and beyond. You don't have to wonder, you're the one I want, yeah. I'm gonna write you love songs to show my feelings. I could tell you I'd rather sing it. Throw your name in the chorus of a love song story so catchy, like everybody wanna sing it. You don't have to wonder, you're the one I want. They have all the answers when I take the floor. Now when it comes to uncertainty, I've never been more sure. Darling, when it comes to you, I never had one. The face of love, the woman in my dreams. I've been dreaming about it. Get that on that guitar now, come on. Your love has grown. Now I'll kiss you right on the forehead. Say, hey, baby, what's wrong? This ain't nothing, I just love you because you never made me wonder. Oh, you're the one I want. You're the one I want. How about we get nice and country and western on this lovely Sunday. Two-stepping now,
How's everybody doing out there? We're the Flatland Cavalry, live from the Amusement Park Studio in Lubbock, Texas. We're happy to be here tonight for doing our humble stream, brought to you by our friends Flecha, Azul, Tequila, and Tecovas Boots. We're back here at the studio where we got started, and we're going to play these songs. It kind of got us out of the garage and all over Texas and then outside of Texas, and we're just going to kind of relive that for a night. It's good to be back here. We're going to have some fun, tell some stories, maybe some jokes. Anything to do to alleviate you from your quarantine blues up wherever you're at. This song is a song I wrote right down the street at the Texas Tech Library, and it remains true. All that remains after this one is just a good memory. Flower drawn on the sidewalk.
take you home.
School at Tech, and every time I hear that song, it just reminds me of just us going to school and just kind of just no worries and just being young shitheads, kind of, you know, just chasing girls and all that stuff as you do as a young 20s. I don't know, but
as you do when you're in your own
20s, yeah, right.
Well, good. Sure. Speaking of chasing girls and young 20s and all the great things and the good, the bad, and the ugly that comes with that one, it brings us to our next song on the Some Folks album. I remember whenever we were kind of putting all the songs together, One I Want felt really good. It's like, what's the one that you want to put into your, you know, you put the CD into, back when CDs were a thing, by the way, but you put the CD into your car and it's just like, what's, you know, the first tune. I remember One I Want feeling really good, and it kind of grooved right into a good memory, and then we had to, it's like, oh, this is going to be a really happy album. But just kidding, because the next two songs are blues songs.
Can I get right back down?
Yeah. Kind of brings me to this next tune that I had to learn the hard way after telling somebody that I cared about truly. I used words that I shouldn't have used, and I regretted it, and I felt terrible, and you can't take nothing back. And I remember I just was left with this kind of heartache. It was my own fault. And I also learned that if you ever ask a woman if she loves you, and she says, I don't know, there's a good chance she doesn't love you. There's a good chance your ass is going to be walking home in the cold.
Tears from your eyes. I said, do you still love me? And you said, I don't know. Left me standing in the February snow. Oh no. And we were the couple others tried to be. You're just you and I'm just me. But I meant every single word I said. Just not those words, it got us in the end. I really wish that you'd come back. I just can't do this on my own. Krishna. Every night I sleep, I dream of you. I guess sometimes some dreams don't come true. But I gave up on counting sheep. I just stare at the door until I fall asleep. And I pray that one day you might come through. I really wish that you'd come back. I just can't do this on my own. Cause every time I close my eyes, I'm underneath that street light in the cold. As you fade into February
and hard, just like it felt. All right. This next song is, I happen to be from a place called Midland, Texas, and that's where I met this guy, Jason Albers, over here. Me and him have been polluting the earth together since we were 12 years old. And,
that's a great way to put it.
I remember we were 12 years old practicing in your stepdad's house, right? Your folks' place.
Yeah, my parents'.
Yeah, your parents. And I remember... just Pat coming in and just kind of like opening the door, but hey, Jason, talk to me for a second.
I'm home.
Yeah, hey, you guys want to keep the noise down?
Yeah.
We've been, I just remember we've always been jamming together, and we moved from Midland to Lubbock, which they call the Tall City, and me and Jason were going to school, and we'd go scour all the open mic nights and stuff as soon as we got here, and kind of settled into what we were supposed to do and go to school and get degrees and, you know, do the status quo and stuff, and just trying to make our parents proud, and as we were spending their money, you know, to go to school. And so, and speaking of that, I was, before making the trek from Midland to Lubbock, I was asking my older brother, Chewy, who's a CPA out there in the Tall City, and he said, you know, if you're going to waste mom and dad's money, you might as well get a good degree. And so I was like, all right. I don't know, I want to play music, but it's something we got to do. So I went and got an accounting degree, and I realized immediately I don't think that's what I'm supposed to do, you know? So I felt like a blues song needed to be written, and this is what I come up with. This one goes out to my brother, the CPA out in the Tall City.
Sounds nothing like a blues. Thank you.
nothing to do except go down to the bar each night and drink till two. I hate my job, I'm always in a bad mood. I fear I'm coming down with a case with tall city blues. Well, I'm a CPA, I've got my BBA from TTU. Well, I crunch numbers in a high rise, counting barrels of crude. Me and my buddies bitch in the break room, cause our boss went golfing this afternoon. He left us to fend for ourselves in our tall city blues. A tall city dream, it is a difference in a month for Venetian blinds and stained concrete floors. I lay back in my king size bed each night where I sleep alone. I'm dreaming about my next move out of these tall city blues. This morning, did you not hear the news? We took too much out of the ground, and we knew what to do. Tonight, no one gives a damn whether your collars are white or blue. We'll drain our glasses by the masses and make a toast to the tall city blue.
If you're caught up in the city, or whether your collar's white or blue, it doesn't matter. Our hearts go out to you, and we thank you for choosing to spend your time with us tonight. All your support literally is keeping us afloat. We hope our music is doing the same for you. So tonight, we cheers to you. Raise your glasses to us.
Let's drain our glasses by the masses and make a toast to the tall city blues. Oh, tall city dream, it is a difference in believing and making a living or loving what you do. Raising a family among strangers and wild kidders who are brought here by the pool. We'll all be strangers soon. It's all city blues. We'll we'll all be strangers soon. Let's all sit in blues.
Brag on Reid, like, dude, he's definitely been the most productive during COVID.
Yeah.
Since we've been off in March, not only has he learned to make homemade tortillas, pasta, and ginger beer, and grown a farm, this dude learned fiddle, and I'm proud of him. Not even like I'm a big brother figure or something by any means, but he's kicking ass. Like, he grew a beard too. It's like turned into just I don't know. Just, it's awesome to see, man. Yeah. So.
Putting in the hard work to learn those double fiddle songs, you know, it's a lot of work.
A lot of work. I definitely appreciate it. To anyone out there that wants to learn fiddle, be prepared to cut off all ties with every other relationship you have for a few hours a day, because that's what it takes. It's insane.
You get so many.
It's the hardest instrument I've ever tried to learn, and I think it's notorious for being one of the hardest instruments to learn. Yeah, so
kudos to you too, Wes, man.
Thank you.
Well, yeah, but Wes doesn't count.
It's less impressive. He's already had 20 years.
He's already as hell, so.
Well, as promised, we have a couple of special guests tonight, and we reached out to our good friend, Mr. William Clark Green, to sing on this next song for us live tonight, but he couldn't be here. He's playing a show. So I was thinking, I was driving down the road and thinking, man, who would be a good fit for this song? It's got that rustic, authentic, gritty, just awesome, authentic country sound. And the first one that popped in my mind was from my good friend from Mississippi, Mr. Jason Eady. Would you come out and join us, my friend? Everybody at home is doing this.
Yeah.
Sounded good.
Thanks, brother. We look up to you as a songwriter and a musician and just a overall human being. So thanks for spending your time with us tonight, man.
Well, thanks. It's great to be here. Great to be a part of it. Hey, you know, they said when Haggard was learning fiddle for that Bob Wills tribute record that they made him get his own bus. They really did. Yeah.
See, guys? See? He has the right idea.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Well, this is an old story. I have a couple pieces of evidence for this next song. Our good friend, Mr. Roy Johnson, the only two pictures known in existence of him are these two, which were taken after many beers on a Wednesday Lubbock afternoon, evening, and you can zoom in on that for the camera. We had a little too much fun, and someone took a picture of Roy the next day, and we looked at it. I opened my phone, and I was like, man, you look like a coyote. Like, it looks like what your job is. And he's like, man, I don't know what you're talking about. He hopped in his truck and drove off, went to class, and when he came back, I wrote this song right here in my garage. It's called Coyote. Well, I spend all day sitting in the shade, waiting in my pickup truck. Not too long, a lawman, he drives by and he stops to see what's up. So I had to pull on over and give my eyes a break. You're a busy man, there's nothing to see here, so I send him on his way. I see his taillights fading and I grab my glass of tea. Truth is, my name's Roy Johnson, Coyote is my trade. About 5 minutes later, the mosquito bush starts shaking like it was afraid. 15 men, women, and children jumped in the back of my Chevrolet. Saw them trembling in my rearview mirror through my eight-beard shades. Said, "May I'm on Roy Johnson." Coyote is my trade. He won't hear me coming. He won't see my face. I've cut that trail 1,000 times, all without a trace. It's my line of business, and it ain't a pretty thing. My Jason, come on.
Well, I did what my mama told me. I got my four-year degree. Now I'm an expert in logistics, and I move product from A to Z. Yeah. Now Glucane's got a plan. If you're looking for my services, well, Vigo, I'm your man. I'll get you across at Rio, you through the USA. Tip the hat and say my name's Roy Johnson. Coyote is my trade. Johnson, Coyote is my trade.
I had that Chevy parked right under my usual spot of shade.
Well, 5 minutes later,
the ski bush started shaking like it was afraid. 15
federales jumped out, and they all knew my name.
www.jasonedy.com. Is that right, Jason?
That's right. That's
up. Check him out on Spotify, iTunes, Instagram, anywhere you can find somebody on the internet these days. This next tune's a little tune about kicking the devil off your shoulders when he tries to weigh you down. Whether it's our own fault, whether we have too much fun one night and we have a little hangover and you just, you know, whispering in your ear, have another.
Been there before.
Yeah.
Too many nights at the Blue Light Live, huh?
Yeah. This is probably one I wrote after a low night after the Blue Night.
Pickle burners.
Yeah. So it's called Devil Off My Back.
Don't
till the very end. I'm gonna climb that mountain with all of my flatland friends. And when I get to the top, I'll turn around and yell, but then I'll go back to hell. I hear them coming, trying to take my soul.
Sometimes I think the only way to beat the devil sometimes.
Start a sentence with sometimes and end it with sometimes.
I think it's called a palindrome. You just have a good time with your buddies and you cheers and you have a good time and you cheers to the good times and you work through the tough times together, and that's how you beat the devil. You get him off your back. Salute.
Absolutely.
Cheers to you.
Someone smell Wesley's drink. I think he has water.
No. Cheers to you at home listening.
Did he wince? I don't know. Mm. Yeah, start that.
Oh, yeah, okay.
No, start that.
Yeah. That's just how you.
Yeah.
Next song is called Stomping Grounds, and this one's about going back home to your hometown, wherever that is home for you. For me and Jason, it's West Texas. Reed's out there in Farmersville. Wesley came from Comanche. We all came. Johnny's out in Leveland, and our buddy back here, Adam G's from New Mexico. We're all coming from some dry, dusty places, and you have to learn how to have a good time in a place that's not always aesthetically beautiful, and you find a good time there, and it's your hometown, it's what you make of it, and
you gotta feel it more than see it. Art told me that.
This one's called Stomping Grounds, y'all. We'll be right back. on your damn boots, dance on my headstone. Bring a bottle of Tennessee for two. Up daisies just for you. Yeah, yeah. And you can find me there. You can find me there. You can find me there. I ain't going nowhere. And when the sun goes,
Wesley's head off with that.
All Adam's noise is coming at the cab right behind Wes.
Yeah, yeah, that Leslie's just
blowing that booty, baby.
Yeah, that's true.
Everybody listening at home, sitting in with us tonight on the Tickling the Ivories, as Jason says, playing the guitar and the mandolin, Mr. Adam Gallegos. Great young talent out of which part of New Mexico, Adam? Carlsbad, New Mexico. He puts the bad in Carlsbad. He's gonna help us bring in this next song. You make it sound so pretty, Adam. Wanna take us through again, man? This next one's called Goodbye Kiss. Starting with a goodbye kiss. Should've just walked right out that door, and I wouldn't be sitting here drinking, thinking about a bet I want just one more. Wish you would've told me that you never loved me anyway. Then I might be in just a little bit better shape.
shouldn't ever turn around. Looked you in the eye, girl, you know it ain't fair. That stare cuts me like a knife. Should've kept my hands in my pockets, so I didn't have to give you one last hug. Maybe then I wouldn't be so fucked up. Somebody shouldn't have to be means to an end. And maybe it was just lust, better off as friends. I just can't get that damn kiss, love of my mind. But
sad stuff out of the way for our next guest, who is a ball of thunder or ball of lightning, I would say, and I mean that as a compliment. Would your guests at home clap your hands, snap your fingers? From Tulsa, Oklahoma, please welcome into Studio A Miss Caitlin Butts, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, Cleto, you need to make the skill of shedding one single tear at the end of a song.
Oh man, if I could practice that, I would.
I could make him cry.
There you go.
thanks for joining us again tonight.
It's good to be here.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's been 4 years since we recorded this song, and since I met you literally in this room right through this piece of glass.
Singing this very song.
Singing this same song. Yeah. And I'm so grateful that you sang on it, because I feel like you made the song itself more impactful, not just because you're a great singer, but it just added some, your spirit to it. It just added this element to it that made the song bigger than just one sad person. You made about two sad people, which is amazing.
Which is what we are.
we met each other through a kind of a melancholy song, and we're going to get here hitched in October, so it all worked out. This one's called "Rock and We Work Out," folks.
One, two, one,
a life where we work out, but there's a house upon a hill. The front porch going all of the way around, and a flower pot on the windowsill. We sit and watch the sunset while the kids play in the field. 'Cause in a life where we work out, there's a house upon a hill.
Joining us, all you folks at home, Caitlin Butts. This is live. This is a live show.
Speaking of live show, can I ruin this song for everybody that is watching? I just think it's funny that every time we play this song live, you'll see somebody on stage. What's the lyric? You still bite your lip when you're looking at me that way. It'll either be John or Wes or somebody.
We all bite the wrong lip,
you know.
Yeah, on a good day, it's all.
So everyone goes like this, and we all look at each other, and we still laugh like we're 7-year-olds.
Yeah.
So I don't know if you ever had a live show and you see that.
Look for it.
It's stupid.
For it.
It's so dumb.
We've done it every
time. Who's next on, please?
Yeah, that's other than folks getting engaged to that song, which if anyone gets engaged to any of our songs, I think that's a beautiful thing. Regardless, but I've seen folks get engaged to that song, and I don't even know if that song's happy or sad. And so it's kind of interesting. All the while you're biting your lip, folks are getting engaged to a melancholy song. It's lots of strange things happen at live shows. And speaking of strange things and strange times, we had a lot of fun and cool times in this little town, this Texas town, about 8 hours southeast of Lubbock, called College Station. And we'd go down there, our buddies went to school down there, and we heard it was the land of milk and honey. We come from dry West Texas, dusty plains, and you go down there at the right time of year, and there's lush greenery and flowers.
Around
and
Chili Fest in the spring.
Yeah.
I think spring is the best time for Texas, man.
It's
beautiful.
Yeah.
Highway 6, too, when you go down to College Station. I cut you off, sorry.
No, it's good, man. It's just like a daydream. Every time we play this song, I kind of have that kind of flashback of just riding in the back of pickup trucks. Over there, apparently, it's not, you know, illegal or something. You just drive around in the back of pickup trucks and just go sightsee and meet a lot of nice people. And I left there feeling very inspired. And me and Jason actually penned this song in the garage, in the old three-car garage we used to, you know, make music in. Yeah, out there in Lubbock. And I just remember always feeling that nostalgia every time I'd come to College Station and come back. You'd always be like, oh, that was awesome. Green trees, nice people, good-looking people, good times. It was fun. But anyway, yeah. I digress. But this one also goes out to our dear friends at the Blue Light Live who, like many venues, you know, during this pandemic are kind of struggling and everything and to keep their doors open. And if it wasn't for that bar in this studio, I really don't think, I'm not sure where we'd be right now, but thank God for that place opening their doors every Monday night and letting us go in there and try to write songs and tell our stories to people. And this is one of them right here. This is called Traveler's Song. Station, them boys are good to me. Hill, I burned Northgate down. I've been the life of the party. I seen that 12-man town through a tailgate seat. The road goes on, I can't stay long. I've got shots to see. Raised hell in the panhandle, I live young, wild, and free. Northern winds kicked my rear end, they got the best of me. Found myself stuck in all of it, playing my songs free. A blue light light, but the road goes on, I can't stay long. Well, I've got shots to say. Sometimes this road gets lonesome, and I wonder how you been. I can't help but think she's probably somewhere better off with him. But if you ever hear my songs, and you still love me, darling, hurry home, we can't stay long, cause we got shots to say. We got lots of sights to see once this whole pandemic's through. Till then, help us sing along. I said, oh, got time for one more song for y'all. Thank y'all again for listening to us. Thank you to our buddies at Flecha Azul for providing the good times tonight and helping us put on this show. Our friends at the Amusement Park Studio, Scott Ferris and his crew, for letting us come back here and relive this album and just tell these stories. And just, it's a great blast from the past. Also, our friends Caitlin Butts and Jason Edie, I'll make sure and check them out. And our friends over at Beeps.com for putting this on. This is the last song of the album, and it almost wasn't. If we never would have recorded this song, I don't know. I got to backtrack. We almost didn't record this song, and so I don't know what the album would have been named. You know what I mean? But I just remember we brought this song to the studio the day that Caitlin Butts came in. We already pressed for time. I think Scott had to begin mixing the following Monday, and this is like Thursday. And I call Scott, and I'm like, man, I got one more song, and it just feels good, dude. I don't know. It could be a title track. And he's like, all right, bring it to the studio, man. We'll see what we can do. And so,
how to piss off the producer 101.
After his board, was this before or after the board?
I can't hear it.
It was before. Okay. Yeah.
So, yeah, this was just this was probably the Pandora's box that we opened that caused his board to burn out afterwards. Yeah. But, yeah, we bring him this song, and Scott, being the fearless creator that he is, never afraid to turn over any stone, is like, absolutely, bring it, Vato. And he probably hung up and was like, but so we bring him the song, and he's like, man, this is super cool. And we live tracked it like we're doing right now, and we all set up, and we didn't have time to, you know, really create a masterpiece of a puzzle or nothing, layering stuff. So we just live tracked it, and it ended up being one of my favorite songs on that album. And when you go back and listen to it, I feel like sonically it kind of opens the door for our next album, just kind of more raw and authentic kind of sounding, you
just
know.
Live tracking and just getting in here and trying to feel, you know, rather than put pieces together, you know. Yeah. Neither's wrong, but it's just what we're trying out, you know.
Yeah, for this song in particular, it kind of fell that way, you know. Yeah. It's the only way it could have been recorded, like we're doing it tonight, right now. Thank y'all again for listening to us. We're the Flatland Cavalry. We love you. Appreciate all your support. All this, any money that's generated tonight is, it's going to help fund our next album, which we're going to record this fall. And we're really looking forward to it. Cannot wait to get back out on the road and play music for y'all in person when it's safe to do so. But until then, you guys stay safe out there. Stay uplifted. Be good to each other. Love each other. Take care of each other. And remain humble. Here we go. We'll leave you with a little humble tune right here.
Scar on the board for the life.
days I'm gonna head my ass back home. Gonna tell you that I love you, gotta let you know. It's you all along, we're doing this for. Oh, everything we have to the humble folks. Plan to give it all back to the humble folks. Seems everybody these days is blowing smoke. We'll keep you 15 minutes, give me something more. Something bigger than you and me. Gonna do right by our family. And put a scar on the board for the humble folks. Oh, right now. You put a scar on the board for the humble folks.
Asked me to do one extra song here at the end, and I love these guys. I love playing with them. I think they're a great band, and so I thought I could do an old song. But I wrote this song a few weeks ago, and it's just kind of made for a band. So I thought it'd be cool to just see what happens here. I think it's gonna feel really good. Cleaning up and back behind the bar.
Jenny pulls a shot and then I take the stage. She likes to move to my groove when the crowd is light. It's quiet round here for a Saturday night. Well, I pay up to the minute that they close it down. I look across the room. Ain't nobody around. Jenny says, come on, and she turns out the light. It's quiet round here for Saturday night. It's quiet around here for Saturday.